Well, I'm joined by Mark English here. Mark's going in the 400 metres today, Mark. And I suppose first I'd say to you, Mark, always exciting to get an opportunity to run in a big event here on your home track.
Exactly. I love running in Ireland in general, but to run back here in Letterkenny in front of such a huge, like, there's huge crowds coming out here today. And, like, this is, I suppose, the third meet of the three meets that they're holding now annually in Ireland, and it's great, like, because you're getting athletes from every continent over, and it's really taken off, and I think it's putting athletics back where it needs to be in this country. And fantastic to be out here in front of people like I haven't seen actually in maybe 1 or 2 years, so it's great to be home.
Yeah. Letterkenny AC put in a huge effort to put this together, Mark. I mean, you've been involved since you were a very young lad, so very gratifying for all these international athletes and national athletes to turn up here today.
Yeah, it's fantastic. Like, I'm bumping into guys that I'd meet around in the European circuit, and it's strange to have them in your hometown. And it's great exposure for athletics here in Donegal, because it's such a great county for athletics historically, and it's great to see it continuing here, and hopefully the legacy continues right through, you know, for generations to come.
Everybody watching your career very anxiously, hoping for great things, and you've done great things in the last couple of months, Mark, obviously. I mean, you said very early in the year that your target this year was the European Championships in Zurich. Can you believe that that's now, what, less than a month away?
It's hard to believe, actually, yeah. And I suppose I've two targets, really. One is to break the Irish record, and that's the second one. And I'm feeling very confident about my racing this season. You know, I've had a complete mental change this season. I'm just more confident about races, taking them by the scruff of the neck, getting out there top three or four on the first lap, and, you know, putting myself into contention over that last 200 metres. And so that's the real important thing for me, just being a bit slightly more aggressive this year, and, you know, getting consistent training sessions behind me. I got a great winter block of training behind me, and my summer sessions have just strung together very fluidly. So it's all coming together very nicely for me right now, and I'm looking forward to Zurich.
Yeah, it's interesting that perspective that you brought to it, because obviously everybody felt that the talent was there, but I mean, you need to gain experience at the top level, really, Mark, competing, and you've got a lot of that this year particularly.
You do. I mean, the jump between junior and senior is just, it's absolutely gigantic, you know, and you need the experience at the different levels. Like, junior level, you get away with so many different tactics, but when you get to senior level, like, the differences between the athletes' ability is just so minuscule, like, so you really have to be skilled whenever you're coming into the races. And so I'm only getting better every year at it, like, and from race to race. I learned a lot last year at the World Champs in Moscow and at the under-23s, and you know, I'm taking all those experiences and learning from them.
Yeah. We watched you in the team championships here a few weeks ago as well in the 800 metres. I mean, that was a race you just decided you were going to take on at a very early stage and coast home. Is that the type of attitude you're going to have to take with you, do you think, to Zurich? Obviously, the standard might be a little bit higher there, Mark.
Yeah, well, I was just really confident going into the race, and that was probably the main strength I had. And, you know, tactics aren't going to be the same in every race. That race, I just had to make sure that I got the win. I knew I was the strongest in the race. Going into Zurich, I won't be the favourite. Like, you know, you got your guy, Bazet from France. Then you got the two Polish guys who've ran quicker than me this year. But, you know, it's great. It's a good confidence to know that I've beat the two Polish guys already in New York. So, yeah. You know, whenever it comes down to it, I know I'm capable of actually beating any of those guys. So sure. I'm really confident going into the race.
Was that New York Diamond League race, was that a watershed in your career, do you think, the way you performed there?
Yeah, I think it was probably the best race of my career, just in terms of showing no respect to the other athletes. And that's really what it's about, because, like, if you do start showing respect, then they're just going to bash you about. And 800 metres is a race where that sort of argy-bargy goes on all the time. So you really need to stand up for yourself and just be counted out there.
Sure. They say, and I mean, it's easy to say why they say that the 800 metres is the toughest race, because it really has become pretty much a sprint now. I mean, you can compare it with the 200, you're going on the 400 here today, but the 800's almost a sprint from start to finish as well, Mark.
It is from time to time, I suppose, but then other times you have a very slow race and it's tactical, and the last 200 metres is a complete burn-up. And I suppose that's why it is, for me, tougher than the 400 metres, because the 400 metres is just flat out every time. So you got to contend with a bit more tactics, in my own opinion. But you have other tough races, like the 400 metre hurdles is tough as well, and the 3K steeple. But I love it, because you've got so many different dimensions going on. First event, not running lanes, and then you've got all the argy-bargy, you've got tactics. As you say, it can be a complete sprint from start to finish as well. So there's just so many things going on in the 800, but I love it for that reason.
Yeah. And of course, the key thing as well is to keep fit now, and you've had your problem with injuries and illness before big races as well, Mark. I mean, that's another element that people sometimes forget about. You've got to be right when you go to these major championships.
Yeah, I suppose you just need to monitor yourself before these races. I've started using a reactive strength index up in UCD to kind of make sure that I'm nearly ready for these championships now, and there's other things that I'm doing to monitor my progress coming up to championships to make sure I'm peaking right. So that's what it's about for me this year, and just, I suppose, progressing this summer form that I have right now, right through to Zurich, because, like, the shape I'm in at the minute, I know I can be a contender.
Yeah. And what would be success or not success for you in terms of the result in Zurich, do you feel, Mark?
well, I really want to make the final. That's my goal. You know, I don't train all winter not to make this final. So, and when I make the final, you know, I always say anything could happen. That's the other great thing about 800 meters is, you know, when you make it, it's not as predictable maybe as a 400 meters or some other event. So there's so many tactics that come into play. And looking forward to getting out there. And, you know, I've got to get a revenge on a few guys like the Brits and that. So I'm looking forward to getting back out there.
So a medal at least to take home with you?
Well, I'm just going to say final right now. And the other goal, obviously, is the Irish record this season.
Okay. Wonderful to talk to you, Mark. We wish you well in a month's time in Zurich.
Thank you very much.